You'll often hear it claimed that lobsters are biologically immortal. So is this true? No. No, it is not. So what's the source of this staple of social media timelines that lobsters can't die of old age? To begin with, cells make up all living creatures on Earth from humans to lobsters. Shocker, I know. However, cell replication is limited based on nucleotide sequences, called telomerase, which are found on the ends of chromosomes. In a nutshell, telomerase prevent the strands of DNA from coming undone and also prevent them from accidentally fusing with neighboring chromosomes. The issue is that these end caps get shorter and shorter each time the cell divides, owing to the fact that the enzymes that duplicate the DNA, with a little help from short pieces of RNA, cannot do so all the way to the end of the chromosomes. So something gets cut every time a replication occurs. Telomerase ensures that what is cut off isn't critical information. But the result of this shortening each time is that telomerase eventually become too short to provide an adequate buffer. For reference, human cells can only be replicated around 40 to 70 times before the telomerase become too short. This leads to the cell no longer being able to correctly replicate and cell death. Lobster cells work a little bit differently. A lobster's body produces quantities of the enzyme telomerase even into adulthood. While humans and other vertebrates also produce telomerase, our bodies only usually produce it while in embryonic form. What does telomerase do? Well, it continually repairs the cell's telomerase, keeping it from becoming too short. The result is that the DNA in the cells can continue to replicate indefinitely, hence why it is often claimed that lobsters are technically immortal. The problem here is that when most people hear biologically immortal, they think it means that if a lobster isn't killed by some predator or the like, lives in a suitable environment, and has an adequate supply of nutrients to supply their biological needs, the lobster never gets old and can live forever. But the truth is that there are many factors that go into aging, a number of which aren't well understood. Not just a cell's ability to replicate itself. DNA damage happens over time regardless of telomerase length. While much of this gets automatically repaired via various mechanisms, genetic mutations do occasionally occur from things such as oxidative stress, potentially resulting in cellular deterioration or malfunction. With regards to the lobster, evidence at hand appears to indicate that do in fact die of what we'd usually call old age eventually. How? Lots of ways, similar to humans. For example, beyond potential environmental damage to their cells causing issues, we know definitively that how the lobster grows and the metabolic energy required to do it greatly affects their lifespan. Humans grow through childhood and adolescence until they reach a certain size, after which they usually do not grow any bigger, at least not vertically. A lobster's body, however, never stops growing. Lobsters grow in size during a process called molting, in which they shed their hard exoskeletons from claws to tail before growing a new one around a bigger body. A young lobster may molt several dozen times before its first birthday as it rapidly grows. The process slows to about once a year by around age 7, and then once every 2 or 3 years after that. The largest lobster ever caught weighed in at a whopping 44 pounds. For reference, a typical lobster you'll find in the store or restaurant usually rings in at about 1 to 2 pounds and is around 5 to 10 years old. The bigger a lobster, usually, the greater its age. However, molting takes more and more energy as a lobster increases in size, and the amount of effort it takes for even a 30 to 50 year old lobster to molt kills between 10 and 15% of lobsters every year. But just because lobsters can potentially continue to grow and molt up until their death, that does not mean they always do so. Even if they have sufficient food available and ideal environmental conditions, elderly lobsters have been observed to stop molting altogether, with the theory being that their bodies simply no longer have the capacity to do so, likely via lack of needed metabolic energy. This is a major problem for lobsters as it often leads to shell disease, a bacterial infection in the shell that can form scar tissue between the lobster and the shell. If they are able to molt again later, they potentially have the problem of scar tissue binding the inner body and the shell, which can cause the lobster to become stuck and die. Shell disease can also lead to other problems, such as shell rotting, with the net effect being the same. The lobster that no longer molts dies. So how long do lobsters actually live before dying of these types of so-called natural causes? This isn't clear at all. Estimating how old the largest lobsters ever found are comes with a huge margin of error. But for reference, using several different means of trying to judge the age of lobsters, the overarching average lifespan in the wild of various types of lobsters out there is thought to be around 30 years for males and around 50 or 60 years for females. So if you want to use as the definition of biologically immortal that no known point in which cells will stop replicating barring outside influence, then lobsters are possibly biologically immortal, but that's very misleading as there is so much more that goes into real-life biological immortality than just if the cells have a point in which they will definitively stop being able to replicate. And we humans don't yet fully understand all the factors at play, nor exactly how much telomerase really plays a causative role in aging. If body and cellular aging only had to do with telomerase, few humans would be said to have died of old age before around the age of 120.